Hi, I'm Jerry Gala. I'm a member of the Corman Air Park team. I'm also the person primarily responsible for the investigation into the cause of the crash of C-IAUE. This video may scare some of you. That's not its primary intent. It scares you into checking over your aircraft, then it has succeeded in its purpose. On this beautiful summer evening of August 17th, 2009, this aircraft, a modified Sylvaire Bushmaster, took off from Corman Air Park on a routine training flight.
We'll be practicing south of Corman Air Park.
It never returned. Its wreckage was located the next morning by a member of the Corman Aero Club in a field 3 miles southeast of the airpark. 56-year-old veteran flying instructor Vern Reese and his 28-year-old first-time student Ryan Shute were both killed on impact. Transportation Safety Board of Canada, or TSB, investigated, but due to their attitude and poor techniques, were not officially able to determine the cause of the crash. The official TSB finding of a Class 5, or cause of crash undetermined, probably would have stood if it had not been for a completely accidental discovery made by one of the Corman Air Park team. This piece, the first piece of debris found in the crash field, was found not to fit the right wing where TSB had placed it, but the left wing, which they had abandoned. This discovery caused the Corman team to launch a full-scale investigation of their own, and ultimately discover the true cause of the crash. A separated glue joint on the trailing edge of the left wing caused the virtual complete separation of the top fabric on that wing. This caused the aircraft to become uncontrollable, and it crashed a short time later. The Corman's team release of the full crash report and the accompanying mail out to all Transport Canada registered Bushmaster Norseman owners put the team in touch with a large number of people in the Canadian ultralight segment. It quickly became apparent that many of the ultralight fleet were suffering from the same problems that plagued C-IAUE. It also became obvious that due to ignorance or denial, there were many aircraft flying out there that needed immediate attention. Canadian ultralights are not required by law to be inspected, but they are required to be kept in a safe condition. AUE was ultimately brought down by a fabric separation. This immediately tends to imply badly deteriorated fabric. The fact is that the fabric on C-IAUE was in acceptable condition. Its demise was the result mainly of improper fabric attachment. Over time, it would appear that rib stitching or rib lacing has become almost abandoned on ultralight aircraft. Some fabric systems even advocate not using it. Indeed, most of the present-day glues and primers are more than strong enough to carry the loads imposed on them. What has become overlooked, however, is whether or not the underlying structure was designed to carry these loads. It has become commonplace to just glue the fabric to the underlying structure and ignore the fact that the fabric was, in many cases, originally intended to be mechanically attached to it. Many ultralight aircraft are held together by glue, mainly in the form of epoxy. Glues are very strong in shear, or force pulling across the glue joint. They are also strong in compression, or force pulling against the glue joint. They usually fail miserably in tension. This Husky Norseman wing shows how important correct fabric attachment is. This is the upper aileron gap seal. The aileron fits here. This is where the gap seal is glued to the rear spar. If the fabric is attached here, when the wing lifts, the gap seal glue joint is primarily in shear. If the fabric is attached here, the gap seal glue joint is primarily in tension. This will eventually cause the glue joint to fail and separate. This is exactly what happened to IAUE. If you own one of these aircraft and the fabric was attached in this manner, and most that we have seen are, then probably you have very little option but to rebuild your wings. As important as fabric attachment, or some may argue more so, is fabric condition. Fabric that looks to be in excellent condition can, in fact, be completely unairworthy, and the opposite can also be true. Automotive finishes are usually very glossy and look great, but they are a very poor choice for application to fabric. As they age, they become very brittle and often crack and flake, exposing the fabric underneath to sunlight ultraviolet radiation. Brittle paint can also have a drastic effect on the tear strength of the fabric. Tools for fabric testing are both expensive and usually not accessible to ultralight owners. There are some simple tests, however, that can be done. The simplest test is simply to see if you can put your fist through it. If you can, or if the fabric or paint shows significant damage, then it is recover time. A little more scientific method, but not much, is to throw a steel ball bearing or golf ball at the fabric hard. If it goes through, well, again, recover time. I hope this short video has been informative. Check your airplane. Remove those inspection covers. Have a good look around inside. If you don't have them, contact me. I'll see that you get some. Check your fabric attachment. If you can't do this without putting your fist through it, don't fly it. Don't think of it as damaging your aircraft. Think of it as saving your life. Be safe and happy flying. Corman Air Park now offers a complete wing rebuilding service for all Husky Norseman and Sylvaire Bushmaster aircraft. This completely eliminates the problems with the aileron gap seals. We also still offer our remanufacturing service for Safe Flight Mounties and our Subaru engine conversion system. Full service to most types of ultralight aircraft and our flying schools make Corman Air Park a great place to fly. Please give us a call at 306-931-0822 or email us at cormanairpark@gmail.com.